We want to make it easier for mothers and families to have babies, not harder. That includes supporting the availability of fertility treatments like IVF in every state in America. Like the overwhelming majority of Americans, including the vast majority of Republicans, conservatives, Christians, and pro-life Americans, I strongly support the availability of IVF for couples who are trying to have a precious baby. What could be more beautiful or better than that? Today, I'm pleased that the Alabama legislature has acted very quickly and passed legislation.
I will say, I do, and I get some of what people are saying, because there are some people who are criticizing him, saying you literally were going after people like Ron DeSantis and Brian Kemp and others for passing their own state legislation regarding that. Yes, he was. He did. This is where he kind of gets in his own way. I don't like that he used the phrase abortion rights, because I don't believe that that's a thing. Just like I don't think that's an existent, that doesn't, you got to be careful about the language that you use and to not validate your opposition by using their language. So I think that, and this is why you have to be careful in a primary. You can't just, you know, throw punches and not have any regard for the future. Because now there are going to be some people, and I'm seeing them right now, they're questioning his sincerity and whether or not he would actually stick to that, because he was so combative with governors that were doing this in their own states. And I think that that's a perfectly justifiable thing to point out. I mean, you're literally just pointing to the stuff that he actually wrote and posted on his own platform and in things that he said in interviews. If this is his position, then aside from the fact that he said abortion rights, I don't think that it's a bad political position. And we're going to talk more about that, because we've got to look at past, we've got to look at how some of these issues have been performing in elections and how to do it better. One thing too, this is what I get really aggravated about. Whenever anyone, people I know, good people who are pro-life, whenever I see them try to have a conversation about this issue, and they are trying to discuss strategy in which that you would use to protect life going state by state, and then they're accused, which is the formula of calling someone a racist that the left uses, they're accused of not being pro-life or as pro-life by people who are like the Susan B. Anthony organization, or, and I don't dislike them, but I see some people really trying to impugn the characters of others by suggesting that somehow they are less devoted to life because they have a different strategy. I find that specious. I find it malicious. I find it leftist. And I find it undermining the very cause that you're stating that you want to go out and support, that the cause that you want to champion. And there's a reason why I say this. If you look at some of the past six elections where you've looked at it state by state, pro-lifers haven't done too well. Some of it's messaging. Actually, I think all of it's messaging. It's not because that doesn't sell. It's because you've got to get better at the messaging. And you can't be having these little, these fights about strategy like this way out in the open. And be accusing people of being less, having less of a regard for life because they want to approach it state by state incrementally, so it's not an all or nothing gamble for them. And you can't have this be all or nothing, or you will lose. It is an incremental fight. And it's also a stronger, by doing it incrementally, it's legally stronger, which we're going to talk about coming up. But his remark, I didn't like that he used, he posted on his platform, he said abortion rights. And you can't use that phrase. Is he, two things. Is he the best messenger? No. Is he conservative on this issue? No. But is this a strategic pathway that actually would cement and place safeguards and gain pro-life more than they've gained thus far electorally, state by state, and taking it, taking the fight like this? Yes, I actually think this is a smarter move. There's a reason why Democrats are trying to make this a federal issue. You can, there's a reason why they are fighting this going state by state. And it's not because they don't think they can win. If they wanted to marshal their forces, they could. it's easier for them to try to make this a federal issue, and they need it as a get-out-the-vote mechanism. Do not grant them this. Trump came out and said that he supports the... He was happy that Roe v. Wade was undone. He supports states' rights. He came out in favor of IVF and said that this abortion is an issue that should be left up to the states. Now, two issues. I think that his position strategically is the correct one, and I'm going to explain that. However, I don't like the fact that he said abortion rights in his statement. Don't use the language of the left to denounce the left, number one. Number two, I do think that primary Trump is at odds with general Trump, because you can't go hard in the primary and go after all these governors for doing within their state what you're now saying that you support. So that creates a problem, because it gave the impression, and I don't think that he ever actually changed his position on this, but his hardcore opposition to Florida's pro-life law that passed through their legislature, that his hardcore opposition and criticism of that and his criticism of what Georgia did definitely sold the optic that he was against states' rights on this. Absolutely. And he was a lot quieter about where he stood with it being in support of states' rights than he was the federal. So that's created a problem for him, or at least for the people who are trying to figure out where he stands most sincerely on the issue. I think what his statement, though, what he is projecting strategically is correct. And the reason I say that is because pro-life issues have been taking a beating at the ballot box. And pro-life groups, as united as they are, sometimes they seem so fractured. Because you have the Susan B. Anthony group, which they do great work, but they go out there and they say it's all or nothing. Well, that's, you're guaranteed to lose if you don't look at it, I think, as an incremental fight. And I don't think that it's fair to impugn someone else's character or question their commitment to pro-life causes because they're looking at an incremental strategy as opposed to an all-or-nothing strategy. I find that incredibly disingenuous, and I feel like, particularly for people of faith, it betrays the faith that you claim and the God that you claim to serve. So don't cast aspersions on the characters of others simply because they favor an incremental over an all-or-nothing approach because they want to have lasting wins. That being said, and we're going to talk more about this, we got Yates coming up as well, but this going state by state, I think, makes it harder for Democrats. Democrats want this to be abortion to be a national issue. That's why they had Kamala Harris going into the abortion clinic and all this stuff. They wanted it to be a national issue so bad, and I think Trump robbed that from them. Regardless of where you stand on him as a candidate, I think this was a strategically correct move to make, and it's a legally safe one because it's a lot harder to go at abortion state by state than it is federally. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.